That might be something I might have to do a rant on. Why the hell they call it the Even Flow DDT? But anyway. Elbow drop right there. And he's got the leg hook. There's two. No. Forget about it. Ah! Ace Reed taking the low road. Son of a bitch. Ah! Helmsley with one of his freaking clotheslines. I swear, if you talk about clotheslines, nobody hits them like Christopher Helmsley. There you go. I mean, I dare you, fans. I dare you to name me one person who can hit a clothesline like Christopher Helmsley. You ain't gonna tell me that anyone can. And there's a DDT there, not quite the Even Flow. What's Helmsley doing here? Texas style pile driver, as Hawkins 09 refers to him as. And wait a minute, the ankle lock! Helmsley with an ankle lock! I notice Helmsley uses it more as a wear down move. Oh! Christopher Helmsley, quite the overpowering presence. Although to this day, fans, I still have not figured out how the hell he wrestles with his baseball hat on and with his glasses. Seriously. What does he do? Does he super glue them to his head or something? But anyway. Ace Reed starting to take over here. You know, Christopher Helmsley was becoming a big crowd favorite for the last few months. I mean, after that issue he had with Danny Legend, who's now on overdrive. Oh, leg drop there from Ace Reed. Speaking of Danny Legend, I know we're going to see him later. And Ace Reed locking up with Helmsley. Oh, and he just... Oh, man. He just smacked him right onto that canvas. Yeah, I know Overdrive's going to have one hell of a night here. I mean, come on, they got LVG and Canaveras and Hawkins versus Ashley Dunn, as Ace Reed was going for the last ride again, but again, Helmsley just counters it. Yeah, I mean, whoa, Christopher Helmsley is just starting to turn up the heat. Whoa! Just clothesline his ass to the outside. And somebody has just been busted open like a cheap jar of spaghetti sauce. That would be Ace Reed, I believe, who is marinating in his own ragu. And wait a minute. The ankle lock! Ankle lock there from Helmsley, and actually it is Helmsley who's been busted open. It was hard to tell with the camera angles, actually. DDT there. Yeah, as if wrestling with your baseball hat and sun and glasses on wasn't already enough of a problem. Now you have to worry about the blood streaming down your face. Oh, man. And Helmsley. I mean, no disrespect to Ace Reed, but Helmsley's really been pwning him for the last 2 minutes. And Helmsley. Even Flow! There's another Even Flow right onto his damn head. And that should do it. Helmsley wisely moving him to the center. There's the three. Helmsley's got it. Very good. Very good way to get things rolling here for Aftershock. So, Christopher Helmsley picking up the win here. And, like I said, good way to start things off for the Aftershock brand. But let's send it back to CJ Hawkins 09, because it's time for a little more overdrive action here at the Summer Bash. So, Hawkins, it's all yours, man.
Thank you very much, Shady Cage, and what a fabulous matchup that was. And now, our next championship match is now for both the EVA and the World Tag Team title up for grabs in a tunnel unification. So, as you can see, the World Tag Team champion, the Angels. Now, it's interesting to say that the last time these two teams wrestled, the Dynasty won in Madison Square Garden back in 2007 on Christmas night. The Angels defeated the Andersons in a 2-out-of-3 call matchup. And now, a year and a half later, they're meeting each other again. But this time, both the CBA and the World Tag Team title up for grabs in a unification matchup. Boy, oh boy, oh boy, what a matchup this is going to be. And here comes the EVA Tag Team Champions, the Erickson's, Andersons. Sorry. And they're ready to rectify the situation. Yep, the Andersons, EVA Tag Team Champions, twice. I believe last year, they won the EVA title, tag team title, at the Summer Bash. I believe they were the first team that won. Now, 1 year later, they won an opportunity of a lifetime to win the World Tag Team Championship. See the Andersons pissing off the fans. Man, they really hate the Andersons here in the Dunkin' Donuts Center in Providence, Rhode Island. They must really hate these guys. And here we go. The first of the three title unification matchups. Speaking of unification matchups, also the U.S. title and the World Internet Championship will be up for grabs over Aftershock. It will be Brandon Moore and Stephen Kell in that type of matchup. And then you got Shawn Matthews and Steve Farrell in a matchup for the EBA Championship and the BYU Championship in a unification matchup. That's later tonight here at Summer Bash, but right now, let's focus on this one. As you can see, Mike Angel is in full control so far. And a headlock takedown by Mike Angel. Picking up Dennis Anderson. In his corner, attacks in Dean Angel. This is not some ordinary title matchup, it's all or nothing. Double or nothing, I like to call that. It's now or never for these two teams. Oh, what a stop by Dennis Anderson. These two teams have got to fight like there's no tomorrow. Like, this is like their last chance. And this is no tomorrow for these two teams. Oh, nice reversal by Dean Angel. Wait a minute, what's he doing here? Nice hurricanrana by Dean Angel. Going for the cover here, Red? No, doesn't get it. Great maneuver by Dean Angel. Oh! Man. Irish whip to the ropes. And, oh! Great high flying maneuver by Dean Angel. Nice bulldog. Tags in Mike Angel. And they're both stomping on Dennis Anderson. And, oh! Great leverage. What a great dropkick by Mike Angel. Oh, wait. Oh, nice reverse DDT by Mike Angel.